Good afternoon and welcome to Audiotree Live. Today is Monday, March 6th, 2017, and we're honored to have with us, back in the studio, Microwave.
There is the rusty hammers up in heaven, around the base of God's great golden throne. Sculpted me the archetypal villain, if our children's stories I was told. And I've been told,
God.
live in the studio with Microwave. What's up, boys? Welcome back. The last time I saw you was at Raya Fest, and we watched Brand New together. And I still think that was the best show I saw last year. It's hard
I
to
think
say.
That might have been one of the best shows I saw my whole life.
Are you serious?
For real.
Hell yeah.
They were on it that night at Raya Fest.
So on it, seriously. And you had just finished up that Motion City soundtrack run, right? At that point, the farewell tour. How long was that? I'm not sure.
That whole tour was like 4 months, but okay. We were only on the first 3 weeks on the West Coast.
Okay, cool.
Which was awesome. But it also kind of sucked because we live in Atlanta and it started in Portland.
Oh, so, got it. Yeah.
It was a good.
So did you fly there and then rent a van, or did you drive out?
We drove.
Oh boy, what's that? What's that trip?
Man, I don't know. We broke. We took like 6 days to get there.
Yeah. Okay. Okay. Cool.
We've done some marathon runs before and about went insane. So
right, right.
We made sure we. Started a tour with our sanity.
Definitely, before you lost it by the end. Yeah,
exactly.
Those guys are awesome for tons of reasons. RIP to Motion City Soundtrack. But I'm just curious if you learned anything from them, you know?
They allowed us to, me and Wesley crashed on their tour bus on one of the last nights.
Yes.
We got to party with them, and it was the peak of my life.
Second only to
Brand
New
Riot Fest.
I saw
you had a poster of them out there, like a signed poster of Motion City Soundtrack, and Matt had a lip ring?
Yes.
Respect. I've been wanting to get my eyebrow pierced.
Which one?
I don't know. Is there like symbolism
with
that?
I have no clue. Anyone? Michael's the one with all the piercings.
What's the eyebrow piercing protocol?
Yeah. Anybody know? I don't. I honestly have no idea. Okay. I'm curious about. Well, first of all, I want to know about boiled peanuts because you talk about them a lot, and it's this idea of yours. So I was looking up just on Wikipedia, pouring through the history of boiled peanuts, and it's apparently like attributed to South Carolina, but there's also it's all over the globe and whatever. But so, do you have like a favorite?
Oh, yeah. Well, I mean, I can go on for hours, but there's this guy in Dahlonega, Georgia. So my rule of thumb for boiled peanuts is the shittier the sign, the better the peanuts.
Okay, yeah. That makes sense.
He's got, it's like this little shed on the side of the road, and he has 300 homemade signs that says, stop now, hot peanuts, all this stuff. And I nicknamed him Thummy. He doesn't know that I call him that because he talks real slow, and he's trying to get a bag to open, and he goes, come on, thumb, work. And I was like, oh my gosh, this is the coolest guy in the world.
And come on, thumb.
Thummy's got the best nuts. So.
And what makes them good? Other opinions as well? Like, agreed with Thummy's nuts?
There's the green nuts.
Spicy.
Okay. Yes.
I like the spicy.
Good, like, which specific flavor?
What
about them?
Yeah, what about them? Yeah, both, maybe.
You just have it. Actually, a lot of people have it and they don't like it, and it's weird to me. But I actually think that might be my ultimate life course is to open a boiled peanut stand.
In the end, like after all this stuff leads to a boiled peanut stand.
I'm sure that I'll be just as broke as I am now.
Yeah, it's a perfect way to stay broke.
My goal is to try to save up like $50,000 or $100,000 and buy a trailer and an above ground pool and a lifetime supply of margarita mix and tequila.
And then
I'm going to open up a boiled peanut stand on the highway.
And just travel around with that setup. So that's a startup business idea. Are there others? That's the one?
Oh, no. I am full of business ideas.
I'd like to hear them. I'd like to hear them from others as well.
Let me think. I feel like every day in the have some stupid...
I want to start shit cases. Actually, so I would call it a shit case.
Start over.
So I have this case for my cab.
Yeah, which is...
just cardboard with duct tape on it.
But it's very well made, considering its components.
I'm on my second one now, but the first one lasted about 4 years.
Wow.
And all for the cost of a roll of duct tape.
Yeah, for sure.
You know, I think shit cases could really get off the ground.
Yeah, because you could sell them for super cheap, because they're super cheap to make.
Oh, yeah. And it honestly takes a little bit of time to... wrap a whole cab, so you know it's worth the service. It's more of a service than a product.
Yeah, really. Yeah, exactly. Yeah, it's more of a kindness done from you to them.
Yeah. Exactly. Yeah.
Tito, I feel like I cut you off at one point earlier.
No, yeah, we were talking about spicy, but
spicy
boiled peanuts.
We can go back there.
No, that's
okay.
Cool.
Okay, cool. Well, we can roll into more. So, or did you have something else to say?
I was just gonna say, I think Ty is also perfecting his recipe for a. Scott tape, Scott tap, Scott step, Scotch tape, Scotch.
That's
He's opening a
distillery. Distillery.
If you actually look it up online, you can find it at, like, in an interview that we did or something.
Yeah. Oh, that's awesome. Yeah.
We haven't changed our jokes in the last, like, 2 years.
Yep. Everyone watching is like, I heard them say that.
Yeah, like, this is all. This has already been done. They haven't changed it anyway. Cool. Okay, thanks for sharing. You guys can go into your next set.
Sweet.
Can get this hanger through the window of my car. I'll never leave my house again for anything, I swear. Pacing in the driveway, I'm in living sense of fun. We're sacking hot dog buns, then spilling water. Into your bed.
Somehow I made off with your key. Now I come when I please and go where I wanna go. You were the only thing I like, and you've been with me all summer. So are you somewhere out with your friends? I'm back here blowing up your cell phone. Cause I've been practicing my lines, so you've been
Audiotree Live. We're in the studio with the microwave. All right, so I would like to talk a little bit about texture. I feel like Stovall, at first glance at least, is a pretty straightforward rock record, right? Like the song starts and the song ends. But on this record, you have songs like Roaches, you know, like the end of Lighterless, like Wrong, even Drown, where there's some just like more, I don't know, ethereal stuff, some like spacier stuff going
visceral,
on. I'm just, yeah,
ethereal.
Visceral. Yeah, yeah, exactly. I'm just curious. I'm curious what like the impetus was to go for more sonically adventurous pursuits.
Is that me?
That is you.
Hot mic.
You can take a second to find where that is.
I'll just unplug and talk to you in the middle.
Okay, cool. Yeah, totally.
I guess we one of the main things when we were working on Much Love is I feel like we didn't really, we have kind of a wide variety of influences.
Right.
And it didn't really reflect as much, I guess, on Stovall. We were kind of trying to figure out how to write songs in general, and we wanted to like experiment more with I mean, I love like Radiohead. I'm trying to think of like noisier ones that might be kind of like in reference to more like what you're saying, Brand News.
Yeah,
another right. one that incorporates noise in a really cool way.
Sure.
And
Queens of the Stone Age.
Yeah, Queens of the Stone Age
right,
is one of my
right.
favorite bands.
Cool.
He always would say, "What would QOTS do?"
Queens of the Stone Age do. Yeah, that was actually, I think while we were in the studio, that was the main thing. Really,
that was like your mantra.
What would Queens of the Stone Age do?
Right, and so then you're just trying to like bring all these things that you like into the sound.
Yeah. Yeah, just because it's more fun. I mean, I guess like writing music is really like you hear things and then you want to like do you sort of get to like mash up. Like, what if you had like Tom York made a band with Josh Homme?
Yeah.
And then they had the Kylesa drummer or two drummers on that one record.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Right.
Just like you can just being able to experiment with different things sonically is like what makes things fun. And if you have like I feel like it to an extent, like every band in the world is like sort of ripping off their influences.
Definitely.
To an extent or whatever.
Definitely.
So like the only thing you can do to like try new waters is to try to rip off as many people at the same time as possible. You know?
right. There's a there's this dude, Mike Longo, who's a like jazz musician, and he talks about jazz specifically, but I think it applies to music, as going through three stages of imitation, realization, and maturity. And that like first it's just you're just copying the bands that you like. The imitation stage is where you're copying bands you like. Realization then is like, you know these tools, now you're going to use these tools to your advantage. And then wherever maturity comes, I suppose, is where you create your own sound. But at the very least, I feel like Much Love shows that you guys are in stage two, right? Like,
yeah.
Maybe stage three, I don't know. But,
probably,
you know, like moving
two.
Into...
We're excited. We've been like writing new stuff too, and we're having more and more fun.
Yeah, for sure.
And being able to incorporate different things. I bought a baritone guitar.
Yes, very cool.
The band called Oceana made the Clean Head EP,
yes,
where they played those like 10 electro baritone guitars, and
yeah.
I heard that a couple years ago. I was like, God damn.
That EP is amazing. Also, TT&G, Henry from TT&G plays, or Hank, he plays baritone guitar sometimes. I mean, they do different stuff, you know? But yeah. Other insight on that, or did like he kind of say what y'all agree with? Okay,
yeah,
cool.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Yeah, I was going to say there's some strange, like, cool, strange stuff. Like, Neighbors opens up with kind of like a like doo-woppy almost sound.
Yeah.
Or like,
Yeah, we originally were going to have that be the first song, and so it was like the record cover was like the monkeys, and then you like started it.
Yes.
And we originally had it mixed, too. We recorded it all like mono in a room in Travis's house. Travis actually recorded all of our albums.
Yes, yes.
And he's Tyler's brother, but he recorded Stovall and the split we did with Head North, and he's recorded Much Love.
Yeah.
But we recorded it with like a put in like a koozie over the bass drum and like tried to make it sound like we were trying to like make it sound as much like Stand By Me combined with
that
monkeys
was
as possible
reference.
And then it was just like it kind of like didn't have much replay value when
yes,
it was like
okay.
It was just like mixed really obviously different when like the song came in or whatever. It was just like completely different song, so the first minute was just like weird as shit, and we were like, people are just gonna fast forward over
they hit play and they're like microwave, nope, like moving on to whatever band is in the playlist. I'm curious your involvement as far as like your role in mixing. Do you feel like, you know, I've asked this before, but do you feel like fifth band member or whatever, you know, like where, like when you're recording, you're adding your own flavor to it, you're adding your own taste to it?
I'm as hands off as I can be. I don't like anything to be my idea, but if there's a part that needs work, I like to work with the band and help guide them to a good idea.
Right.
If that makes sense.
Right. Yeah, totally. And like, do you also, are you like fat trimming role as well? Like, hey, you guys should get rid of this, or more like,
I'd say, well, yeah. Stovall, we did like more proper pre-production.
Right.
And then we just came in for Much Love, and they were touring a lot while that record was going on. And so there were a couple songs went through several iterations before they were done.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
Dole, cool. Actually, the song we just played was originally 10 BPM slower.
Interesting.
And was more of like a swing ballad type song.
Yeah.
And then we, once we did the, what would, WW
QOTSAD.
It was the motto, Owed Queens is the
stage. And then you were like, cool, I'm making
like,
this weirder.
They do like the, we were trying, or it's not the same tempo, so it doesn't really feel the same, but that song, Make It With You, or is it something like that?
Yeah.
It's on Air Vulgaris. Make It With You?
I don't know.
I wanna make it with you.
That one.
Anytime, anywhere. It has like the cool, like.
Yeah, yeah. Okay,
like,
before.
I've liked the, like, the Nine Inch Nails and bands that have like they'll keep that like a beat going the whole time.
Yeah.
It like makes it really awesome to drive to and stuff.
Definitely.
We've sort of like historically always had like a really big dynamic of songs.
Yes, yes.
Probably like a Manchester Orchestra influence of like the, and Brand New too.
Definitely.
Having like the soft part and then open up into a big part kind of thing. And I love that too. It's really fun.
Yeah.
But yeah, we've been working on new stuff, trying to do different types of.
Yeah. Well, I feel like Wrong fits in that direction as well.
Yeah, that
it's
was
like fairly steady.
Thought with that. And the song about the play too.
Yeah, Drown. Yeah, for sure. Okay, you can go into your last set. I'm just curious, one thing for you. I know you've been playing a few acoustic sets or like, you know, for other things, pacing or things like that. I'm just curious how you think about that. Do you approach the songs differently? Do you just say, hey, I'm just going to play them however I want? Or do you even play, you know, different versions of the songs?
I play through them and some things just like kind of don't work acoustically. So I have to make something to sort of revise it or whatnot. But I mean, for the most part, I just keep it the same. And most of the songs initially are written with an acoustic guitar, just like messing around. So it's sort of been, it's like reverse imagining it.
Yeah.
Reimagining
the beginning.
Triple positive.
Yeah, a triple, a what a negative. Makes it, double something. Negative makes a triple positive. Yeah, that's
triple,
right. Perfect reference.
Whammy.
Okay, you guys can go into your last set. Thank you very much for sharing.
Thank you.
the studio with Microwave. You can get their newest record, Much Love. They are on tour all the way through April this spring, and they have a show tomorrow at Sub T, so if you're in around the Chicago area, you can come out and check them out. Lisa says hi, and she's sad that she couldn't be here, but she is watching, just so you know. Thank you guys so much.
Thank you.
Thank you for having us.
Yeah,
thank
of you. Course. Thanks to awesome people in the studio and sound engineers, camera and lighting crew for hooking it up, and viewers. You can support the band by streaming or downloading a session when it comes out in a few weeks and send a shout via social media to us or them if you just want to connect. From all of us here at the Audiotree Studios, thanks for tuning in. Goodbye.
Hell yeah.
Cool.
Thank you very much, everybody.